Hi everybody, it's been a long time since I put a video up, but what I've done quite a few videos over the last month, and I've kept them all so that I can put them together and make one episode, because I've been quite busy in work and down on the plot doing a picket fence. I've been doing that now for about 6 weeks, and it's about 85 foot long, so I've had to cut a lot of pieces of wood and get posts in, so it's been a long drawn out affair, but now that's finished, I just needed painting. I'll get my grandson to do that, so all that side's done now, so that means I can bring my little dog down so he can have a run round and not pester anybody else and go onto their plot. I've got a little bit more to do on the front of the plot, to the right of the shed, just behind me that way. Wants a little bit more doing there, and then that's a whole lot done all the way around the site then. So as I said, it means I can bring the dog down and not interfere with anybody else. It's not been such a brilliant month, has it? We've had that much rain, it's drove me mad, but there's an upside to that. I haven't had to do as much watering outside. Now obviously I come down most days to water the greenhouses, but if I don't come down one, I make quite sure I come down the second for me tomatoes and different things I've got in there, me peppers and me aubergines. So I've got the bottom end of the plot I need to do a little bit of concentration on now. So that is my next little project. I'm running away myself there. Actually, my next little project is I'm going to extend my shed that way by 4 foot to make it basically an 8x10 shed. So I've got a little bit somewhere to come down to in the winter and working. I'm hoping to put a little bit of a wood burning stove in there so that I can come down in the winter and do a little bit of work. But if I can't do that, I have got a little heater in there that works off Calagas I can use, and it's somewhere for me to come down and do a little bit of work, potting or little things I want to do, woodwork I want to do. So I'm looking forward to that side. So I want to get the shed extended. So that is actually my next project, not the bottom of the plot. But once I've got that done, then I'm basically all my building on this plot's finished, and I can really concentrate on growing, because I've not had such a good year. My potatoes have been an absolute disaster compared to what other people have had. But you'll see on the video some of the ones I've revealed. I've emptied them out, but it's quite hard to do in one hand when you're holding the camera. I don't use a camera, by the way. I use an iPhone 6, so it's not quite as good as a video camera, but it does for me. Anyway, so what we'll do now, we'll go on and we'll have a look at what I've done over the last month. Decided to do a potato reveal on one of my Saxa spuds. They're called Penton Javelin First Earlies. They've died right back now, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to put them in the air. We're about to empty it out and just see what we get out of it.
Opened it out. Oh, there's a few little.
Yeah, they've come out quite well.
First Earlies, they're not too bad. There's a few there, so what I'll do is, I can't do it one-handed, so I'll sort through it and then I'll show you what I get from it.
Well, I suppose I'm not too disappointed in what's in that bucket from that bag. I didn't expect them to get anything, to be honest with you. But they're quite nice potatoes, just the right size for salad, so I'm quite pleased with them. Right, I've moved my bench away from the side of the shed with the plants on, and I'm clearing this area here, because I'm going to actually bring the shed out
another 4 foot.
It'll just give me somewhere to work in the winter, where I can sit in there and relax, basically. So what I'm doing at the moment, I'm just clearing this ground area so I can get a base in. So I'm going to make the base with pallets and then put an 8x4 sheet on top of it. So that's the plan anyway. Let's see how we go. Okay, so clear most of the ground there. Now all I need to do now is get my pallets and get them level. It's my next job. but not today. Cut the trees back here this morning, so now there's a lot more light on the allotment. They badly needed doing. 26th of July, we've just pruned a lot of the trees back, and I'm just coming to the greenhouse to water plant. It's absolutely teeming outside, but I still have to water inside. And I'm just looking at my aubergine, and you can see the they're just starting now. So I'm really pleased, because I love the aubergine, so looking forward to them. Little update, tomatoes are coming up. And just over here, I've got the black tomatoes, which are started from seed. I wasn't sure whether they'd take them, it'd been an F1 variety, but they've come out black again, so I'm pleased with that. Just noticed also on my sugar babe melon, that one's coming on nice, so that's that as well. So they're all in the greenhouse. I'll keep my eye on that, making sure nothing gets it.
Give you a little tour of the plot. It's absolutely teeming down the drain. I can't do much, but I've now got my plot sign up, so they know it's plot 7. And as we go in, the hydrangea is absolutely starting to flower. Yeah, I'm sorry about the way the camera is, but I'm using an iPhone 6. The runner beans are coming on well. Moving into the greenhouse.
The tomatoes are doing well. I had to take two of the plants out because they were getting black spots, and I think that's due to lack of water. Well, I have been down every day and watered, but for some reason, your sugar babe melon, that's coming on great. As you can see, the aubergines are starting nicely. My chilies are starting. See there? There are my peppers. And there's more chilies, but there's no peppers. I've got one of these at home, and it's actually got peppers on now. Lettuce ready to go in. Cuttings of rosemary, looks as if they've taken. And also my begonia. I haven't got much in here now. I've taken most out of just a begonia. Another cucumber plant. I've had a couple of good cucumbers, so I'm quite happy. And an onion in here, but it's not that successful. So we'll move back outside. Down the plot. Once a good bit of weeding, to be honest with you. There's my leeks, you can see the weeds. My Brussels sprouts. My flowers, my begonias, geraniums, fuchsias. And as you can see, I've practically got all the way down to the bottom now with my picket fence. Onions are doing well. Peas have done really well, and the broad beans. We have the cabbage, they're filling out nicely. Spinach. The sweet corn, I don't know how well that's doing. Some of them seem to be a lot better than mine, but we'll see. Spring onions, got plenty of them. More lettuce. Moving down, potatoes, they were taken out. Not very successful. So, again, me celery and more spinach. And I just can't think what they are now. Isn't it funny when you have a mantle blank? I'll come back to them. Some more beetroot, that's doing fine. Shallots. Moving on to my onions, my big onions. I'm hoping they're going to be quite long, but we don't know. The top of them, as you can see, is quite fast. We'll see how we go there. I've been clearing down the bottom. We've had taken quite a bit of black currants. Also, gooseberries have been gorgeous. The red gooseberry been very sweet. Rhubarb. Now that's just starting to grow again. I don't know how successful that's going to be. My apple tree, which I grafted, that's produced fruit. Nothing on the cherry tree. A few pears on the pear tree. And my cock's pippin, there's quite a few on that. Moving on down here to my comfrey, which I planted in, which I got off one of the lads on the site. That's taken.
So I'm pleased with that. I've also, as I said the other day, I've cut back some of these trees to give me a little bit more more light on the plot. But it seems to be all right. And then ones I was talking about, the names just come to me. Parsnips, how come you can't fit the parsnips? But I pulled one up the other day and it wasn't that big, to be honest with you, so I'm leaving them to grow a bit bigger. The carrots, they're doing well. I've had a few, so they're coming on nicely. I think you see some of them in there. Yeah, they're coming on nicely. I've plenty of strawberries. My banana salots, they're done well. But as I say, I need to do a lot of weeding. The strawberry bed, that's finished now. But I've had a numbers of strawberries from that. My shed, my plan is to extend it another 4 foot that way to make it 10x8, and that's for the winter, hopefully. So, yeah, that's a small little tour of my allotment.
Okay, it's the 5th of August. I'm going to do another potato reveal. I'll have a look which ones we've got here, and I'll empty them out into the wheelbarrow and see what we get.
These are the potatoes we've got left still in the bags. So let's have a look at what we've got here. Duke of York, I think we'll have a look at them and see what we can get out of these. Right, so I've tipped the bag out, and I don't know how promised this is going to be, but these are something's on the top. So what I'll do, I'll clear it out of these and just see what we get and show you at the end. I don't know what you think, but that's a very poor crop in my eyes for the bag. These were Duke of York. So, I don't know whether I'm doing something wrong, but we'll see.